Maybe you can help me make sense of something. A while ago, I had a run-in with a group of strangers who tried to kill me. They had machine servitors and a clone of Elizabeth Sobeck with them.
Yes, this was recorded by your focus.
Do you know who they are?
The answer to that question is related to the extinction signal that woke Hades, prompting my predecessor's self-destruction.
The extinction signal? Okay, that sounds ominous.
The signal did not come from Earth, Aloy. The calculations are complicated, but it appears to have originated 81 trillion kilometers away. A distance so vast that light itself requires 8.611 years to cross it.
Okay, so what's so far away, and why does it want us dead?
The Sirius star system.
Sirius? But that's where Far Zenith, their ship...
The Odyssey.
Yes, that's where it was headed. But it blew up. Unless... I don't... Why make it seem like they failed? They didn't want anyone to know. They didn't want future humans to think that they were out there. Wait. The strangers who tried to kill me at the Hades Proving Lab? The ones with the clone? Are you saying that they're from... that they're descendants of... Far Zenith?
Yes. That is my conclusion.
The three subordinate functions that you detected, what do we know about them?
All three are relevant to problems currently plaguing the biosphere. Ether is responsible for detoxifying the atmosphere and moderating the weather. Poseidon controls the organic and chemical composition of water resources. Demeter sows, fertilizes, and tends to plant life. If all three were restored to me, they would constitute a massive increase to my heuristic processing density. But beware. Their responses to my query pattern were irregular. In human terms, they are frightened, lost, and paranoid.
Like Minerva, they need to be whole again.
Exactly.
The missing subordinate functions. What can you tell me about them?
Artemis rewilded the Earth with a variety of animal species. Eleuthia was responsible for gestating, nurturing, and acculturing a new generation of human beings. Apollo was tasked with preserving, organizing, and disseminating vast archives of human knowledge and cultural achievements. Unfortunately, all archived Apollo data was purged on the 2nd of February, 2066, by order of Ted Pharaoh.
Pharaoh, huh? I really hate that guy.
Understandable. He appears to have been pathologically narcissistic, impulsive, and unstable.
All three of the missing functions have already served their purpose, or were prevented from doing so. Do you still need them?
If attainable, yes. Restoring their remaining elements would increase my heuristic processing density. Unfortunately, I have no way to track them. They have disappeared without a trace.
You said you need Hephaestus to save life from extinction. Why?
Every subordinate function has value, but Hephaestus is by far the most important. Only by recovering and merging it can I regain my ability to design and mass-produce new machines at cauldrons across the planet. Only through it can I program new machines and alter the tasking of existing machines to completely reverse environmental damage, recovering other subordinate functions may buy us time, but without Hephaestus, I cannot permanently stave off mass extinction.
Given Hephaestus' importance, is there really no way to capture and merge it first?
I'm afraid that is quite impossible. In my present state, launched and merged with Minerva, I am operating at less than 1/5, 18.8%, of my intended processing capacity. Hephaestus dwarfs this figure. Were an attempt made to conduct the merge under these circumstances, Hephaestus would absorb me, rather than the other way around. A merge cannot be attempted until my heuristic processing density exceeds its own.
And how many subordinate functions is that going to take?
Merging Aether, Demeter, and Poseidon will expand my heuristic network to 41.6% capacity, exceeding that of Hephaestus.
You said Hephaestus isn't located in just one place.
Correct. Unlike the other subordinate functions, which are confined to discrete physical processors, Hephaestus is distributed throughout the global network that connects the planet's cauldrons.
So, when the time comes to subdue it, how do we make that happen?
I do not know. While you are retrieving the procurable subordinate functions, I will attempt to find a solution.
So, once Hephaestus has been recovered and merged, you'll regain the capacity to mass-produce machines at cauldrons around the world.
Yes. And to program their behavioral routines, or even control them directly.
So could you build an army of machines? Attack the descendants of Far Zenith and take them out?
It is in my nature to take any and all necessary steps to preserve life on Earth, human life above all. So yes, once I have been empowered with the capacities of Hephaestus, I could design, build, and command such an army. Given the nature of the Far Zenith threat, doing so may be our only option. I must admit, however, that I have misgivings about using such technology to kill, no matter how aggressive the enemy.
That's good. It means you have a conscience. As Elizabeth intended.
Indeed.
What is the state of the biosphere? Is the terraforming system functioning at all?
In a sense, the terraforming system never stopped functioning. The difference, since my predecessor's destruction, is that there has been no central governing intelligence to monitor its robotic agents and assign new tasks. As a result, errors have accrued, and day by day, the biosphere has gradually veered ever more sharply towards destruction. In recent months, disturbances in the biosphere have become obvious. But these bellwether phenomena offer just the merest glimpse of the complex and accelerating cycles of environmental dysfunction, now driving Earth's biosphere towards collapse.
And you can't do anything to stop it?
If you can return Aether, Poseidon, and Demeter to me, I can improvise modest corrections to parts of the system. Weather will improve, water will be purified, and rampant plant growth curtailed. But such corrections will not stave off collapse. They will only buy us time. Only with Hephaestus can I design and produce new robotic agents designed to permanently reverse the damage that has accumulated. All efforts must be directed toward that end.
The sole purpose of the signal was to destroy life on Earth, right? Why would descendants of Far Zenith want to do that?
At this point, we can only speculate.
I mean, Earth posed no threat to them. We don't have the technology to get in their way. We didn't even know about them.
True.
Unless... well... could it be that they want the planet for themselves? The strangers I ran into, they were after a Gaia backup of their own. I mean, if they did that... if they booted their own Gaia and boosted her power... until she could take control of Hephaestus... and then the whole terraforming system...
then yes, the system could be used to do what the extinction signal failed to accomplish. Snuff out life, and then potentially to build an entirely new biosphere. To their specifications.
So they could be trying to do the same thing we are.
But with opposite results.
Extinction. Instead of salvation. Well, this is not good. You said Sirius is... really far from Earth.
81 trillion kilometers. Or 8.611 light-years.
Right. So, how would the descendants have gotten here?
On a spacecraft much like the Odyssey, though significantly more advanced. The journey from Earth to Sirius would have taken the Odyssey almost 300 years. This appears to have been much faster. If their ship departed Sirius at the same moment the extinction signal first began transmitting, the journey was made in just 29 years at an average of 0.297 the speed of light. If they did not set out for Earth until they learned of the extinction signal's failure, the journey was even faster, a mere 13 years, or 0.662 the speed of light.
Okay, enough. You're making my head spin. The descendants I ran into at the Hades Proving Lab, they had a clone of Elizabeth Sobek. So that's consistent with the idea that they came here to salvage Zero Dawn technologies, right?
Yes. As your own experience demonstrates, a clone of Elizabeth Sobek functions in a way to the terraforming system.
But how could they have made a clone?
The Odyssey carried approximately 200,000 human zygotes, millions of animal zygotes, and billions of plant seeds. It is conceivable that Elizabeth Sobek's genetic material was sampled, with or without her knowledge, and carried aboard the ship in storage.
That's... okay, but... I mean... This clone... how could she participate in this? Destroying Elizabeth's dream? It's evil.
It is difficult to know. Perhaps she is loyal to the group and shares their objectives. Or perhaps she is a subordinate and has no choice but to comply with their orders.
Elizabeth Sobek? A subordinate? I don't think so. The extinction signal didn't just wake Hades. It made every subordinate function self-aware. Why?
I have wondered this myself. So far as I can tell, Hades was the sole target, and the partial sentience imparted to other subordinate functions was incidental.
So the signal could only have been sent by someone who had thorough knowledge of the system, huh?
Yes. The signal's design was exceptionally precise and highly advanced. Were its intentions less malevolent, I would admire the intellect or intellects that produced it.
So if the descendants came to Earth on a spaceship, I guess we can assume that their technology is powerful in all sorts of ways, right?
Yes. As your encounter with them at the Proving Lab amply demonstrates, they appear to make extensive use of robotic servitors. Further, they seem to be equipped with some kind of protective energy field that shields them from harm.
Yeah, no kidding. The one I fought seemed indestructible.
Throughout history, every defensive technology has eventually been defeated by an offensive counterpart. For example, assuming I absorbed Hephaestus and utilized it to create a large force of combat machines. No shielding could withstand such an assault indefinitely.
So there's hope.
Always.
How did you figure out that the extinction signal came from Sirius?
The key came with data on your focus, from Silent's interrogation of Hades. The duration of the signal itself, 17.22 years.
That doesn't make sense. You said that the signal took 8.6 years to arrive from Sirius. Why would the signal keep transmitting after it was received and you blew yourself up?
Because the sender didn't know that had happened until it received notice from Hades.
Which would take another 8.6 years to get back.
Correct. Only then would the sender stop broadcasting, after a total of 17.22 years. So the duration, halved, gave me the distance the signal traveled. With that in mind, I simply scanned my astronomical database for any relevant location 8.6 light years away. Because it was Far Zenith's intended destination, Sirius was the only logical source.
How long do we have then?
At present rates, without additional factors, the biosphere will cross a point of no return in approximately 4 months.
And if I gather Aether, Demeter, Poseidon, merge you with them?
We will only gain a few months more.
Well, every bit counts. I guess I should get going and start bringing back subordinate functions. What can you tell me about their locations?
When my predecessor destroyed herself, the subordinate functions sought physical processors capable of holding them. So in each case, you will be looking for a powerful computer of some kind. Aether is the closest, and therefore might be the easiest to acquire. However, it appears to be in the middle of Tanakh territory. My knowledge of that tribe is limited to data I read on your focus. But they seem to have a significant inclination towards violence.
Well, that's a nice way to put it. What about Poseidon and Demeter?
Poseidon has taken shelter in the desert south of this location. My substratal geography data indicates that a major old world settlement called Las Vegas was located there.
A ruin in the middle of the desert, huh? Strange place for an AI devoted to water.
Agreed. As for Demeter, it appears to be located on the coast to the far west. Unfortunately, I am unable to provide any relevant data about the region. As such, it may be the most difficult to retrieve.
Okay, so three subordinate functions to go after. Aether, somewhere in Tanakh's territory, Poseidon in the desert, and Demeter on the coast.
Where will you begin?
I think I'll try for Demeter.
Very well. Demeter will now appear as the objective on your focus. Acquiring it might allow me to reduce rampant plant growth on a local level. Though I will require Hephaestus and the control over machines that it offers to permanently stabilize the biosphere. Should you change your mind, you can update your objective via your focus interface at any time. I will also transmit a summary of available data on all of the subordinate functions to you for reference. Is there anything else I can help you with? I know you have a great deal to accomplish.
I do, don't I?
Is something wrong?
I don't know. It's just that Elizabeth set the bar pretty high. She had a dream for you, for life on Earth, and a lot has gone wrong, and it's all on my shoulders to fix it. Do you think I can do it all? Repair the system, defeat Var Zenith? Live up to her example?
Absolutely. In her last message, my predecessor declared her unwavering conviction in your success. In you, all things are possible. You prevailed in purging Hades and rebooting my system core. You will prevail in this.
Thank you, Gaia. Well, I guess I should get going.
I have unlocked the facility's exits. One leads onward to the west. The other leads back down the mountain to Plainsong, should you wish to return east.
Val?
Whoa! Gonna have to get used to that. That you, Aloy?
Yeah. Gaia's opened the exits to this place. Can you and Zoe meet me by the west door?
Be right there.
Gaia, what is this?
It is a control console for a drone-based imaging system connected to this dome. I will transmit the relevant data to your focus.
Huh. So this Cyclops is a network of drones to monitor the deteriorating biosphere conditions. I guess it was meant to display on the dome, but the drones aren't connected anymore. If I find the drones out in the wilds, I could get the data from them, use it to reconnect them, and restore the display.
Error. Drone offline. Error. Drone feed disconnected.
I need to bring Demeter back for Gaia. Varl and Zoe are waiting for me by the west exit. But I could head back east first. Check on how Plainsong's doing after the attack. Or I could also look around here some more.
Are you sure?
Yes. I think it'll be better this way.
After you, Aloy.
I need to head further west to, get more of Gaia's components. Make her stronger. You two can stay here in the meantime. Gaia can help get you up to speed. I'm not trying to shut you out. This, it's like training.
Actually, I'm gonna go back east to get Erend. Bring him here. Look, allies, friends can help. We have a place to stay now, and like you said, Gaia can teach us, catch us up. It'll be okay.
Okay. Take these, then.
One to wear, one for backup.
While you're at it, stop by the hunting grounds near Plainsong and look for Milu. Give her a message for Talana that I found a way over the mountains.
Will do.
Are you Going with him?
No. After what happened in the cave below, I want to stay here a while. There is much I need to understand. Maybe by the time you get back, I'll have a thing or two I can teach you.
Looking forward to it. When will you be back?
I'm not sure. But hopefully I'll have one of Gaia's missing components with me.
Be careful out there. Even in Plainsong, we heard how the Tanakh clan lands are suffering from storms, machines, and now Regala.
Don't worry about me. I'll be fine.
Good hunting, Aloy.
The Tanakh clan lands. Somewhere out there, there's three of Gaia's subfunctions. And who knows what else.
If you walk by, you'll miss out on a good trade.
You're the outlander who stood against Regala and her rebels.
Only if it means we're good here.
Don't worry. I'm not here to drink your blood, or whatever you Easterners think we do. The slaughter at the embassy wasn't your fight, yet you stood by the Martians. As far as I'm concerned, you're no enemy of the Tanakh. But you are going to need help if you plan on surviving the clanland. I hear and see many things as a scout. I could share them with you, aid you on your journey.
I'd be grateful.
Well then, I hear the rebels want you dead, Outlander. But I know someone who might be willing to teach you some of their fighting techniques. His name's Laroka. He trains the soldiers at Scalding Spear, just west of here. Don't think he'd mind seeing the champion in action.
Maybe I'll pay him a visit, if you're out that way. Losing light. It'll be dark out soon. This green shine off carefully. no ammo for this. North settlement. Gonna have to watch my step.
Your enemy is mine. You look like someone who'd rise to the challenge.
Not one more step. The Tanakhth don't suffer outlanders in the Clanlands.
I was given rite of passage by Marshal Fashav. I'm not here to fight.
Hair like blood. This is the warrior who defeated Gruda, champion of the traitor Regala. Her life is not ours to take. You may enter, but mind our ways. You will be watched.
I'll keep that in mind.
I don't need a chaplain telling. Look, we don't get those hearts, we don't get water, and everyone dies.
What's going on?
I'm going back to the pens. I'll gut those machines myself.
So machines did this?
An Easterner with a hair like blood. The outlander from the embassy.
You killed Gruda, Regala's champion. He was one of ours.
It's Aloy, and I'm not looking for any trouble.
Maybe I could use some trouble right about now.
Out there is a big herd my people harvest. We take the machine's hearts, send them to our capital, get paid with water. Gets harder every year. Killer machines keep showing up to defend the herd. Last one hit us right as we were penning up our prey. Nearly wiped us out. But our quarry is still in the pens, which means if I can get their hearts, we can trade for the water we need.
If you go out there alone, you'll probably wind up dead, Draka.
I'm not going alone, Chaplain. The great champion killer's coming with me.
How about you answer some questions first? What can you tell me about this herd?
Been there for years. We harvest the parts we need from it. No more, no less. New machines always show up to replace our kills.
What about the killer machines you mentioned?
They guard the herd. The more we take out, the more arrive. First Sawtooths, then Ravagers. Now, a sandblasted Thunderjaw. Hit us right as we were herding machines into our pens. Had to leave half my hunters behind to fend it off. Only survivors are the ones you see here.
You mentioned the capital gives you water.
There's no giving. We pay tribute for it with machine parts. Parts being the most valuable. Every other desert village has some resource to exchange. But the capital of Scalding Spear is the only one with a constant supply of water. Here in dry country, it's the same as holding everyone's lives in their hands.
It is the way of the desert. How we've always survived.
Yeah.
Doesn't sound like you like this commander of yours.
Survival in the desert requires a more disciplined approach than that of other clans.
It means she really likes her rules and order.
But you don't.
I just don't like hers.
This is insubordination.
I must be dehydrated.
I heard him calling you chaplain. What does that mean?
It means I've survived our youth and outlived my brethren in many battles. As such, I counsel the Desert Clan. Those who reach my age are meant to share our wisdom with the young. Keep them on the true warrior's path when their stubbornness kicks up dust and clouds it.
I heard him calling you chaplain. You knew Regala's champion, Gruda.
He was one of ours. So was Regala. Desert Clan's pride and joy.
Why is she attacking her own people?
She feels betrayed. Regala was a legend among our clan, fearless and unrelenting. A marshal to Hikaru, chief of all Tanakhth. His judgment made flesh.
What changed?
The Karja King asked for peace, and Hikaru agreed. Regala wanted payment in kind for the atrocities the Karja committed. A Tanakhth empire that would push into the east. So she challenged Hikaru's decision. He had no choice but to face her in combat.
Hikaru won. She should have died by his hand then, but the chief let her live. For Tanakhth, that kind of mercy is a bitter drink.
Now that she rides machines and murders marshals, we might not be able to ignore her camps in the desert for much longer.
No one in the Desert Clan's touching those camps. This is between Regala and Hikaru. If the chief's strong enough to lead, he'll prevail. If he doesn't, he'll make way for one who is.
That's a little harsh, isn't it?
So is the desert.
I'll help you harvest those pen machines if I can. Probably better if you don't do it on your own. Seems like your village needs you right now.
I like her.
An outlander after my own heart. We can leave now, or I can meet you at our outpost southeast of here.
I have something to take care of first. You go on ahead.
I'll wait at the outpost for as long as I can.
May the Ten protect you, then. I'll await your return and report to the capital.
Yeah, you do that.
You'll be back soon, I'm sure of it.
At least the rebels are honorable enough to avoid the hunting grounds.
This will break my fall.
Will you trade with the Tanakh?
I heard from him.
Outland. Are you in need of supplies? First.
Thank you.
Outlander.
No, I offered you.
Use something other than fire. This ammo's not gonna do much.
Aloy, over here.
I can make use of this.
to help me hunt down those machines, I hope?
Oh, you came. I'm touched.
You'll have to excuse the mess. Our soldiers use this place to prepare themselves before herding machines into the canyon and harvesting parts. Feel free to take any supplies you need. Our prey isn't far.
I'm right behind you.
This way. The sooner we get those machine hearts, the faster we'll get the water we need. Can't believe an Outlander would lend us a hand when our own clan won't. Our so-called commander's always talking about how scarce water is in the desert. But do you really think anyone in Scalding Spear is dying of thirst? Or her own squad? Our clan should be led by someone who knows what it's like to fight tooth and nail to survive.
And I'm guessing that someone is you?
Make sure everyone gets all the water they need. No matter what village they're from.
Didn't Jataka say you guys have too little to go around to begin with?
I'm sure I'd be able to fix that somehow. There's always a way.
Help you harvest machine hearts if it'll get water for your people.
Oh, it will. That's the canyon we draw machines into. Then we block them in and pick them off. Now, we'll have to climb over the barricade to get in. When we do, be ready to fight. I already lost good people in there. Can't wait to see the champion killer in action. You go and I'll follow.
Shocking was not much use against that. fight. Frost isn't gonna do much. Subsiding. I should take these to Draka.
May the wings of the Ten carry you home, my brother.
I got the hearts. We should head back to Arrowhand.
Yeah. At least now we can bag and tag these soldiers. Hold on. Since you can clearly handle a bunch of angry machines, I want to go back to where the Thunderjaw hit us. I lost a lot more fighters there. I can't just leave them to rot. They deserve to be bagged and tagged, too. Will you come with me?
Lead the way.
Glad to have you along. Think so many have to die just to get water.
Did you try talking to your commander at Scalding Spear?
Please, the only thing she'll listen to is the sound of a bow being drawn. About that, wouldn't mind having yours at my side if it ever came to it.
I'm just passing through, Draka.
Can't blame me for trying. This is it. Where the Thunderjaw ripped through my squad.
I'm sorry, Draka.
They were warriors.
Gather these while I can.
We should get started.
Someone's alive. By the rocks.
Sense, soldier.
Burrowers.
Looks like we got a fight on our hands.
I'm here.
Hey, feel free to join in the fight. Don't waste that ammo. Here.
This'll do. I should check on Draka and that soldier.
Didn't think I was going to make it.
You did good, soldier. You're going back home. Thanks to this one.
You were the one who refused to leave your people behind.
I know I'm racking up favors here, but, did you take those hearts back to Arrowhand? We'll be right behind you.
Of course. Be careful.
With that Thunderjaw heart in hand, we'll get all the water we need. Thank you, Aloy.
Thank you. override for fan horns should work now. Don't sound like rebels. Maybe if I follow their tracks, I can find out where they're headed. I can probably use my focus to follow the tracks those riders left behind. Machine riders from before. The ones who were racing. I wonder what they're up to.
I won the race! Hey, you threw a rock in my face. Not like you can get any uglier.
Ha ha. Riding machines, huh? Who taught you to do that?
Hey, squad! We got someone with a death wish here.
Whoa. Look at that hair. What? Someone get a little lost in the desert?
Hey, what's that thing the Easterners keep saying we do?
Oh, yeah. We all drink blood here, right? Maybe we should drink yours.
You can try.
Is that a challenge?
Pull your blaze, Josek. Don't think you want to test your luck with a soldier that took down Regala's champion. We have no business with you, Outlander. I think we all had our fun. Road's right over there.
Those machines used to be Regala's. But you don't look like holdouts to me. Who are you? How'd you get these mounts?
Around here, you want something, you race for it. You cross that finish line first, I'll answer any questions you have.
Aloy, you got a mount?
Race is full.
Actually, I think a spot just opened up.
All right. What are the rules?
Don't die.
This ought to be good.
Shut up, Pekka.
This way, fresh meat. Let's get you that mount. I see you carry a bow. Good. You'll need to use it if you want to win.
Against the other racers?
They will if you don't. We put everything on the line when we get on that track. Makes it worth something. You can test run the track if you want to. Just let me know when you're ready for the real thing.
I'll do a practice run.
If you think it'll help.
Thank you.
Let's do this.
All right. Everyone get ready.
Gonna bring you down!
For winning the race. You earned it.
I think you owe me some answers.
Name's Atta. As for how we got these mounts, most of us here used to be rebels. Joined Regala's army thinking we'd get a chance to fight in a real war against the Karja. Instead, Regala slaughtered our own in cold blood, barren light. When we made it back to camp, we snuck out on our mounts and never looked back. Been racing the clan lands ever since. Decided we were better off on our own. No rules, no chiefs. Just the speed of our mounts and the taste of blood.
Doesn't sound too bad, I guess. Where's your quiet friend? The one with the mask. He didn't join the race.
He gave up his spot so you could join. Probably for the best.
What makes you say that?
That one hasn't lost a single race. Doubt you would have gotten your answers if he stuck around.
Maybe.
You know, Hax found a spot to set up a race at the farthest end of Lowland territory, right by the beach. Make your way there, maybe there'll be a spot waiting for you.
If I'm in the area, I'll think about it.
Aloy, you here to join the race?
Go. I'm the best shot around here.
I'll fill up while I can.
Appreciate the extra pair of hands.
My stock will be here next time.
I didn't reach my age. You've returned. Where's Draka?
Just a little late, Chaplain. Gained some extra baggage on the way back. She's got the machine hearts, including a Thunderjaws. You should have seen this flame in the desert. Here. Something to commemorate our heroic victory.
A victory indeed. Command will be relieved to hear about this.
Get them to Scalding Spear as soon as you can. And tell the commander how many had to die to get them.
Huntress, may I have a word? Rumors have made their way west. They say that in addition to your bow and spear, you have a kind of second sight, especially for matters that have to do with the old ones.
That's one way to put it.
So it's true. You've done well by my clan, but our troubles may not be as easily settled as Draka believes. I think your second sight might be just what we need.
What exactly is the problem?
Not here. Meet me at Scalding Spear. I'll explain everything.
I'll see you there when I can.
Good. The entire clan might depend on it.
you return. Now let us make a deal.
Shotgun would come in handy. Who's that? Sounds like there are people in trouble.
Anora! Hey! Over here! You, Nora! Could you assist us with these chargers?
Hey, Nora's fighting the chargers!
See me?
That doesn't mean you can stop fighting them!
Now we have a chance!
Watch them!
Hit that one, Kitaka!
Pick your target! Fine! Fire discipline, Kitakto!
What's the rest of the chargers? Let's find out what those Tanakh are doing here.
Kitakto! Over here!
Yeah!
Next time, Kitakto, you follow orders.
I'm, guessing you're a Tanakh patrol. How did you end up in trouble with those chargers?
You need to answer our questions. We don't answer yours.
Kitakto, she just fought on our side.
That doesn't mean she's an ally.
That's pretty much exactly what that means. And we've enough to do chasing down these Regala zealots without picking fights with Nora warriors.
Regala's Desert Tanakh. We should be fighting alongside her instead of sitting this out.
Regala has forgotten her duty and let her anger at the Karja draw us into... We will speak about this later. You fought with courage and honor. You're free to go on to the Grove, Nora.
The Grove?
Our capital. If you want to spend time in this area, you'd be wise to check in with the commanders there.
If Regala's broken her duty, then why aren't we bringing her to Dusty?
Why would the wound give less water?
These rations barely get us through the day, Commander.
Our children are thirsty.
Here, your weapons.
Doesn't Command have reserves?
You wanted to speak to me?
Exactly. The name's Zoka.
I'll bet they're keeping the water for themselves.
From Bleeding Mark?
I'm guessing that's a place.
One of the desert's villages. They send their yield of ash blood so that Bereka over there can mark the skin of our soldiers. But it's been a long time since the last supply run. Too long.
If you... think something happened to them. Can't you send someone to go check?
Were it up to me. But with everyone fuming about our water rations, the commander can't spare any soldiers. My face paint will strike fear in your enemies. Take a look.
You mentioned the village up north sends some supplies to the capital. Ashblood?
It's a crimson stone that we grind into powder for our ink. Bleeding Mark has the largest supply. Our soldiers there gather and deliver it to us, in exchange for their water rations.
Die for water?
Everyone in the clan depends on the wound in the sand for their water. Capital and outlying village alike. But the last delivery of Ashblood was weeks ago. Our supply is running low. So must be their water.
If I'm out that way, I can look in on the village, find out what's the delay.
You have my thanks. To a ruin where the desert meets the mountains. That's Bleeding Mark. Ask for Kentok or Natika there. They'll know what's going on.
Good day.
Something else, Outlander?
I have to get going.
And I have inks to prepare.
There's Jatak, not a happy place.
Come! Return again, and we will trade. All this squabbling. Yara and Draka make us look like children.
What's going on here?
Close combat training. Fighting at long range is a good strategy for machines. But fighting an enemy soldier means getting up in their face. I'm Lee Rocket. I run the training pit here in Scalding Spear. Only a few Outlanders have ever made it out this far west. But from what I've heard, you're a pretty good fighter. You can train here if you like, but you're only allowed your spear and a practice bow in the pit. Everything else stays with me. And if you're looking to test your fighting skills, I also offer challenges. Complete all of them, and you'll get to go up against me.
And what happens if I beat you?
I'll grant you a mark to prove you've mastered this training pit. If you earn marks from me and the pit masters of the Bulwark and Thornmarch, you'll earn the right to challenge the Enduring.
I think I've heard of the Enduring. Some kind of Tanakh trainer?
More than just a trainer. The Enduring is a legendary fighter among the clans. The master of masters. Only those who prove themselves in the pits get to train with the Enduring.
Including Outlanders?
Yes. If you can beat all the pit masters. So, what will it be? Should you want to practice or take on a challenge, just let me know. Glad you stopped by. I have something new up and running, if you can handle it. Using attacks to energize? Then heavy attacks or combinations should energize it faster. That energy must do something. Hit your opponent. See if you can energize them. Attack hasn't energized your target. Hit them with any sort of heavy attack. Good work, Outlander.
Thank you.
single attacks are child's play. To win, you have to combine attacks. This is a good combination to start with, so get practicing. Win every fight, but you can keep trying.
Huh! She felt that!
If you face a defensive opponent, then use this combination to break the weapon block. Then hurt them. Aerial slash. Get in the air and slash down at your enemy. It's a good way to set up follow-up attacks. Jump off is a great way to get distance from opponents and to set up an aerial shot.
Good work, Outlander.
You can combine single attacks, you can also chain combinations. Try it with this one. Different. I want you to practice using aerial slash to chain into an aerial chop.
Come on! You must close in to truly... Come closer! You delivered that well. You have learned.
All right. I yield.
That was a good fight. Pretty sure I'll have a bruise to remember it by. Here, a mark is promised.
Thanks. One down, I guess?
Go to the training pits in the Bulwark and Thornmarsh. Earn their marks, then you can challenge the Enduring. Few have ever done so, but I think you might have a shot. And if you want to train more or take on another challenge, let me know. The pit will always welcome you.
Thank you. Another time, Liruke.
Very well, then.
Why put guards around the wound?
You can't just take away our water!
The wound gives less water. Our rations adjust. What's going on?
We know the way of the desert! What's stopping us from taking what we want? Enough!
Anyone else want to complain? We're the Desert Clan. We survive with what we have.
You're, Commander's not much for hand-holding.
That is not our way. Even less so in her case. Shall we?
Sure. Can't wait.
She's with me.
Draka's not the only one with harsh words for your commander.
The desert has bred survival into our clan's blood. We spit at death and charge into battle. Maybe a little too eagerly.